The gray squirrel, or Shuras carolinensis, is native to North America, particularly the eastern United States. However, since its introduction to Europe in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, this species has become one of the continent's most recognized invasive species. Gray squirrels were first brought to the UK in 1876, introduced as an exotic species for local estates, with subsequent introductions in Italy in the early 20th century. The species adapted quickly to the European environment, where they encountered fewer natural predators than in their native habitat. Their spread across Europe has been facilitated by human activities, including unintentional releases and their natural dispersal capabilities. In winter, when food becomes scarce, gray squirrels exhibit remarkable adaptability in their dietary habits. Before the onset of cold weather, they engage in scatter hoarding, meticulously burying nuts, acorns, and seeds in various locations across their territory. This strategic behavior ensures they have a scattered supply of food throughout the winter, although they don't remember each location precisely, relying instead on a combination of spatial memory and luck to rediscover their caches. When these caches are depleted or forgotten, gray squirrels turn to scavenging, showcasing their opportunistic feeding behavior. They consume a broad variety of foods, adapting to what's available. This includes buds, bark, and young shoots from trees, which provides them with sustenance when other food sources are scarce. In urban and suburban environments, they exploit human-provided resources by raiding bird feeders for seeds, nuts, and grains, and scavenging around trash bins or picnic areas for human leftovers. Gray squirrels are known to gnaw on the bark of trees, not just for food, but also to keep their ever-growing teeth from becoming too long, which can lead to health issues. Their diet isn't solely plant-based. They occasionally eat insects, bird eggs, and small vertebrates when the opportunity arises, demonstrating a degree of omnivorous behavior. This dietary flexibility allows gray squirrels to survive and even thrive in harsh winter conditions where native species might struggle, further cementing their status as an adaptable invasive species in Europe. Their ability to adapt their diet based on availability makes them particularly resilient, capable of exploiting both natural and human-modified environments for sustenance. Gray squirrels in Europe have shown significant habituation to human presence. In cities, they are often seen as charming urban dwellers, lacking the natural wariness that might keep other wildlife at bay. This adaptation has enabled their populations to thrive in urban environments where native species might avoid human interaction. The practice of feeding wildlife has further supported gray squirrel populations, inadvertently making them more dependent on human-provided resources and contributing to population growth in areas where they might not naturally thrive. Gray squirrels construct nests for sleeping, resting, and raising their young. They typically build two types of nests, drays and dens. Drays are the most common, built high in the forks of tree branches for protection from predators and the elements. On the other hand, dens are natural tree cavities or hollows, used especially in colder climates or when drays aren't warm enough. The construction of drays involves gathering a variety of materials like twigs, leaves, moss, bark, and occasionally human-made items like paper or plastic. In preparation for winter, gray squirrels might reinforce or build new drays with additional insulation, using thicker layers of leaves or moss to combat the cold. They might also choose nests with more southern exposure to benefit from the sun's warmth. The gray squirrel poses several threats to native European wildlife. They outcompete the native red squirrels for food and habitat with their larger size and aggressive foraging behavior, often leading to the displacement of red squirrels. Moreover, gray squirrels carry a pox virus to which they are immune, but this virus is lethal to red squirrels, significantly impacting red squirrel populations across Europe. By altering seed and nut distribution through their feeding and caching habits, gray squirrels can influence forest regeneration patterns, potentially leading to changes in tree species composition not favorable to native species. This dominance can suppress other small mammal species and alter the ecological balance in woodlands and urban green spaces, leading to a decrease in biodiversity. To manage gray squirrel populations, various strategies have been employed. Some regions implement culling programs to control numbers, though this is often controversial and met with public opposition. Habitat management strategies enhance environments to favor red squirrels, while reducing gray squirrel access to key resources or using barriers to prevent their spread. Research into biological control methods, like sterilization and immunocontraception, aims to prevent gray squirrel reproduction. Public education also plays a role, informing people about the impacts of feeding wildlife and the importance of preserving native species.